Before we go any further, just something you should know. In particle filtering, the measurements are typically referred to as the Z's, Z sub T, and not as Y of T. It was just the way it was done. It has to do with whether you're connected to vision or robotics. In order so that it aligns with various papers and other formulations you'll see, we're going to start showing Z's in the slides to come. It also made it much easier to borrow slides from other people because they were using the Z's. All right. So the key to sort of particle filtering is the following. If we have a distribution, and here we have a nice little distribution, which you see is, I don't know what that distribution is, but I know one thing. It's not Gaussian. Now, somebody who's really smart out there might say, well, it looks to me like a mixture of Gaussians.
Well, it sort of looks to me like a mixture of Gaussians.
Yeah, in this particular case, maybe it is. That's just for convenience of drawing. And in fact, there is a relationship between mixtures of Gaussians and particle filters, which we won't even talk about. But basically, the idea is you have a bunch of things which together represent your density. In particle filters, or sample-based methods, what you have is you have a set of particles. And here the particles are drawn out where you can see these particles. It says xt. That means these happen to be our particles at time t. And there's n of them. And you know the bigger n is the better. And you'll notice it says weighted here in parentheses, because sometimes they're weighted or sometimes they all have the same weight. The density is represented by sort of where the particles are. So you see we have a nice high density here. So we got lots and lots of particles there. Okay, not so many particles here, not so many here, and lots of them there. All right, so that's where they are. And if they were weighted, it would be as if you can think of that as having two particles in the same spot. If I had double the weight, it would be like having two particles at the same spot. And now you can say that the probability density that x is some value is essentially the probability, if you were to draw out a particle, that you would get a particle whose value is really, really close to that spot. Okay, and that's what it means to use samples or particles to represent a particular density. And if you're doing that, then your overall goal is you want, sort of as n gets bigger, the idea is that the probability of getting a point from this distribution, that's x as an element of xt, is approximately what the underlying probability was. And for tracking, the idea is given everything we've observed so far. So what are our observations? Remember, they're z's. So given everything that we've observed so far, what's our belief about where x is? And we want to end up with a set of particles that gives us that density.